Welcome to the video news of the week. Last week, the Chronicle reported on a statement issued by the owners of the Balsams Hotel in Dixville Notch that renovations may have been put in jeopardy as a result of a decision by the Colebrook Planning Board to delay approval of a subdivision because of a liquid waste dump. It was announced this week that the board will be holding a special meeting on May 22nd to review the subdivision once again. Meanwhile, all is moving forward for Saturday's auction of the contents of the Balsams. Yesterday and today's auction preview attracted a steady stream of former employees, potential bidders, and the curious. Here is our report.
The Colebrook Chronicle is here at the historic Balsams Hotel in Dixville Notch, New Hampshire. Today is the opening preview for the auction, which will take place on Saturday, in which all the contents of the Grand Hotel will be sold.
Well, I used to help my dad out here. He used to do the maintenance on the refrigeration equipment. I was probably 11, 12 years old. I used to help him, hand him tools.
The auction itself is at what time now?
I believe it starts 9 o'clock Saturday morning. Everything's going good. They say they're going to do it in one day.
Well, I owned the ski shops here for 35 years with Tom Tillotson. We were partners. I see. And mostly I stayed over the ski area. There's all the chairs that came off the original chairlift. Everything is going to be modernized, and it's going to come up to where it should be.
I came here in June of 94 to start the Balsams Apprenticeship Program, graduated in 97, and continued on throughout the years. I was here up until the end when we closed. Right now we're in the what we call the Garmage Department. This is where I actually ran the department for a good many years. It's basically where we would produce all of the melon carvings, the cold soups, the vinaigrettes, everything made right from scratch.
How do you feel about being here, seeing this? It's got to be kind of a strange sensation. Right?
It is, but it's nice to walk through the halls again.
A new tower, which has risen on a hillside just north of the village of Canaan, Vermont, has been garnering much curiosity by the public. The Chronicle looked into this and found that a Vermont utility installed the tower to serve as an emergency services cell tower for company linemen.
The Marion Godzik chapter of the National Junior Honor Society welcomed its newest members during an induction ceremony held in the Colebrook Elementary School cafeteria last Tuesday night.
Organizations like National Junior Honor Society are important because they develop character and focus on those character traits that make us human. They encourage students to be active, not passive.
The guest speaker was Neil Brown, who passed along his former status as advisor to Matthew Heisen. Following the ceremony, the students gathered and cut the cake. Last Thursday, Stewartstown students held a combination bake sale and book fair. Profits from the bake sale went towards the Stewartstown Builders Club.
How much do we have?
The annual book fair was assembled inside.
How about for you, was that? There's cookbooks.
Later in the evening, children and parents gathered to listen to a storyteller who kept everyone's attention with his anecdotes.
In America, you have these things called night crawlers, which I don't know how many years it took me to figure out that night crawlers are worms. Why don't you just call them worms? It's so much easier for those people that come from out of the country that have no idea what night crawlers are, right? It just baffles me. But anyway, I pick up the fishing rod, and I'm like, all right, here we go. I remember how to do this. I'm like, it's caught in a bush, you know. So I go over and I untangle it, and I happen to glance up, and Andy's looking down, going, oh. And I know what's going through his mind. He's marrying my sister. She's picked him. So I'm like,
The annual Teddy Bear Clinic was held last Wednesday as a part of National Hospital Week at the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital. Children were greeted by Lenny the Bear as they were given a tour of the facility.
Thank you.
Oh, wow, look at you guys. Love it. It's
Whoa. So good on them? How is everybody today? I see everybody's got a stuffed animal.
Wow.
Press the button.
Last Friday night, the annual regional high school art show featuring the work of area students was held. This year, Colebrook served as host to the display, which features the work of high school students not only from Colebrook Academy, but Pittsburgh and Canaan as well.
It's Canson paper. It's really thick. It's like a board. Mm-hmm. And I picked out the orange color because I felt like it was really 60s and vibrant. And then I chose my color scheme to be blue and purple, and then I have my highlights of yellow. All of us started with tracings of our pictures, and then eventually we started working without the tracing paper onto real paper, and then eventually we got to this stage.
I'm just curious about the one that this Mallory Medora's picture here. How do you do a tone completely in one color? How did she approach that?
She just put the color on and just kept blending it until she got what she wanted. And then after, she went through and added her shadows and highlights, and then worked on her really small details, like in the eye work.
Well, congratulations. I see you're the Teacher's Choice Award.
Yes.
Very good. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
The Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. Visit their website at ucvh.org. Compassionate healthcare close to home. Steve Bissonnette, AAMS Financial Planning and Investment Management in Lancaster. Visit MrIRA.net. LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at LaPerle'sIGA.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook, offering 10% off Kohler products this month. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Friday's weather calls for rain with a high of 57 degrees. Skies clear up on Saturday with highs climbing to 67. A few clouds roll in on Sunday with a high of 64 and a low of 41. Chronicle reporter Liz Carney traveled to the new Canaan Athletics Historic Exhibit at the Alice M. Ward Memorial Library. The end of the current baseball and softball season will also mark the end of the local varsity team, the Canaan Eagles, who will be merging with Pittsburgh to form a new sports team in the coming year. The display showcases newspaper clippings, old shirts, uniforms, trophies, and other memorabilia associated with the Eagles. The items have been donated by many townspeople and former athletes throughout the years. This past week, the Eagles went head-to-head against Concord, Vermont. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.